happy you could join me on this beautiful day. I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. I'd like to start out by thanking all my viewers and subscribers. I really do appreciate all your views and all your comments, and I always try to get back to you as soon as possible. Today I thought I'd maybe do something of a mixture, maybe of a sacred white crane, maybe with a beach chair umbrella. Who knows, maybe sunset, maybe some waves coming in. I don't really know for sure. But all the colors you'll need and any information will come across the screen right about here. This is a pre-stretch canvas 16 by 20. What I did was I spray painted it with your local hardware spray paint. To get the different hues, I put the painter's tape there for your horizon. Make sure you're in a well-ventilated area and you have a mask on. Then after I did that, I loaded it up with a thin coat of liquid clear after that was dry. This is going to help the oils go on a lot smoother, because you can tell if you missed a spot, the oils don't smooth. They don't go on there smooth. So that's where I'm at. So we can get started. What I'd like to do is start out with some clouds. I think I'm going to take this brush here. I'm going to load it up with some liquid white. Liquid white and liquid clear. Just like that. I'm going to make a horizon. Some people were asking me to do a sunset, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to start in with some yellow, cadmium yellow and liquid white. Just like that, and maybe we'll start it down here. Put the sunset. Going back and forth all the way down. Take some same color and we'll come down here in the water, right where we think the reflection might be. Kind of going back and forth. Cleaning that brush off. I'm going to come into a little fan brush, just like that. Load that right up. Tap. Get some of that lighter areas. Straight across and get that illusion, the illusion of the sun. Some areas might be brighter. Right by where it's hitting on the one side. All the way down. Got some popping up there in that corner. Come down and get some lighter colors down here. all I'm doing is tapping. Get that same look. Now we'll come into some red color, orange. Like a little bit of an orange color, since it's going to be a sunset, just like that. Maybe over here we have it. Goes all the way down. Blend it right into the yellow. Pull it down here in the water too. Same colors. Makes it look like the reflection. Stick in the corner of the brush. Just like that, it's come into play now. Now we'll get some more red, I think. Make it darker. Darker out here. All kinds of things happening in there. Drop some red down in here. Just dropping it here and there. Just get that illusion. Kind of like that, just the way that is. Maybe we could put something back over here. Off in the distance. Now I'm going to clean that brush off. I use odorless paint thinner. It's always a good thing. I'm going to come into some white. I'm going to mix some purple and blue. Alizarin crimson and like a phthalo blue. What that's going to do is it's going to give me a purple color. Because that's what I want to do the clouds with in the sky. Make some clouds. Just do a little, just like that. Maybe circular motion. right across. Maybe there's a storm brewing over there. To clean some of that off and come in and kind of blend it in a little bit more. Make it a little lighter. Just like that. Can I also come into some white? Cleaning the brush off again. And come in this just white. Cap it in. Circular motions. Just trying to get the illusion. The illusion of some clouds coming in. Okay, let me come down. Start putting some water in. Just barely tapping and going right across. Right where I think it might be. Right where I think there might be some water lines. Then the harder you tap, makes it look like there's white caps out there. I'm going to try to make them as straight across as you can. Otherwise, it'll look like your water's going off your painting. And that's not what we're looking for today. Just here and there. All the way down. Further off you go, you're going to see less waves over there. Like that with it coming in. Got all the different colors in the water. Maybe right here it can be starting of a wave. A little bit of a break there. One coming over. Maybe can make another one right here. breaking. Off in the distance. Here and there. Wherever you might think. Add a little bit more there. Make it look like it's turning over. Just taking the corner of the brush and just tapping it. That turning over look. Maybe there's something back here turning over. Every so often you got some waves coming in where it looks like it. Okay, now I think I'm going to put a bigger wave coming in here. I'm going to go right across. Maybe it's coming up right here. Just a little one crashing over right there. Make it a little lighter on top. Tapping. Now, take a little brush. I'm going to come in with some green color and some yellow. I'm going to scrape it in. Get that look of the ocean. Throwing some back here. Get some more white. From that happen. Some yellow. Got some waves crashing back there. I'm wiping that excess off. Now I'm going to blend it in. A little bit of white. right in the eye of the wave. Highlight that just a little bit back here too. Where it's turning over, you're going to have that lightness there. Just in the tip of there. Just the tip of that. Get some oranges. Get some oranges maybe. Got some of that color coming down into the waves here. Reflection. Cleaning that brush off. And we're going to blend it in. Blend it in, but yet still have it peeking. Get some white, go across the top of the wave. Okay, we got that going on. We'll take this brush here, liquid clear and white. Let's get the top of the where it comes down and it breaks. Then you have your water. All I'm doing is tapping. Trying to get that misty look at the edge of the, where it crashes over. Do the same back here. See some of that back there though. Now we'll come into another little brush and we'll tap this in. Get that foamy look. get that foamy look off in the distance where it's all breaking, and all I'm doing is tapping. Now I'll take this brush with the white on it and we'll pull some of this down. Just pulling this down now where the waves, where you got your foam. You have all the dark and light areas. From each wave. Got the layers going. Each layer of the beach. Like that, where it's real rough. We'll highlight it with some lighter colors here. Right where you think that the sun might hit it. Give it that 3D. A 3D look. More white. Just here and there. You might think the light hits off of the tops of the waves. happen there? Different angles. In different waves. That kind of topped it off. Gotta keep stepping back and get a different look. Different look of what you're trying to create. I think this has got to be a little bit more wider. All the way. This come up here, I think. Where it's splashing some. Given that rough look. Out to sea. Okay, now I'll look for a little brush. And we'll put some seagulls in. Put some seagulls off in the distance. Using titanium white, liquid white, and liquid clear, just on a little brush. Maybe we'll have one right there. One right here. All I'm doing is tapping and then going on the angles. Whichever way I think I want it to come in. Maybe that one's going that way. Now I'll get into some white, some midnight black. Draw underneath that wing where they have that gray. Just like that. Playing getting this brush off. Let's come into some beach color. Put a beach down here. Browns and blacks. Maybe we'll have a beach like right here. Right across. Just tapping all this in. Then I'm going to come in with some white. We'll start putting the shadows in. Then we'll start blending it in. Now I got some white. We'll see where the reflection is. Right where you think you might want to have some lighter colors. Blender brush, this one here, and we'll just start tapping lightness. Just tap it. Wipe off the excess. Because we just want that lighter, beachier look. I'll tell you what we'll do. I'm going to go in and grab some of this white with liquid clear with the palette knife and just put it out on the area that I'm working from and mixing all my paints on, cleaning out the majority of it, coming in, going right on top of this, just like that, load it up with some white, and you can come in and tap just about where you want it to be. I think you might be able to get more of a more of the angles and lighter colors. Using this bigger brush this way. Leave some areas in there because you're going to have that where the sand has a little hills and little areas where it's sandy and some dark. get all kinds of things happening. By doing that, clean off that majority of it, come back into the little fan brush that we had. I'm going to highlight it. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab this 2-inch brush, load it up with the white, and then tap that. Tap this where we might want more light. Blender brush. Make it lighter. Make it as light or as dark as you like. Whatever look you're looking for. Also come in and maybe hit some yellow in there. A little bit of yellow in the white. Just on the top of the sand. Right in there. Clean the blender brush off again, since we're going into the yellows. Just barely tapping. Yellows, I think. Just tapping that in. That's getting there. I think that's getting the look that I'm looking for. Now, we'll come in and we'll do an umbrella with the blues. Chiseled edge with the blue, and maybe we'll have an umbrella right up here. I think we'll make it a bigger one. Maybe we'll have goes here. Goes here. Maybe it's like here. We'll pull it out. I'm just shading it in now. Trying to get the right color, because it gets lighter as it goes around towards the light. So I'm just cleaning this brush off now. I'm gonna come into some more weights, to lighten it up. Shading it in. This is gonna take the longest, just for the shadowing. Similar to that, this is going to be a little bit darker. As it goes around, let's grab a little bit of the white, just a little bit. Kind of like that. Well, let's see. Maybe if we just take a little bit of blue down here. Just like that. Okay, now come into the fan brush and we'll do the poles. The pole we need. and stand up. Chair is going to be a little bit of a gray color. And it'll be back here, I think. We'll run it straight down. Smaller brush, that same color in there. Since you're further away you go, these are going to look thinner. Angle's going to be there. And one more, I think. We'll do it. Lower. do the smaller brush, some more, the whiter. More of the white, I think, coming out. Okay, now we'll come in. So that. right, got that done. I'm grabbing some whites now. Whites and red. I'm gonna do the crane. Liquid clear. I'm gonna do the crane now. It's more, a lot of it pink, a pink color. Load it up on a little brush, just like that. Who knows? Who knows? Maybe. Maybe it's right here. It'd be a big. I'm just shadowing it in. Fill it in more as we think that it needs to be, but for right now, let's see. Something like that. It's filling in the back side of it. It's coming down to the point. Big crane right next to the seat. Like that. Now, we'll get a little tiny brush. To put the beak in. The same pink. It's a small little brush. Liquid clear and midnight black. Just like that. And we'll come here and we'll put its beak in. got those long beaks. Then we'll put its eye in. Right there. And we'll put its legs in. All the way down. All the way down to the sand. Now we'll get some brighter red for underneath it, for shadow. Like for in here. A little bit up here. Right where its wing is. A little bit back here, I think. Right where you got some of the clean that off. Come into some just white. We need to just have white for the back of them. We think it might. Similar to that, more pink in to fill it in. Shadow it. Shadow it right where. Right where you think it might. Grab some more white, I think. Liquid clear. Put it on the back. Shade that in some more. Get some more red for underneath. Just like that. I'm going to call this a completed painting. And And I'm going to go ahead and sign it. Sign it in the corner. To get some lighter colors because of the dark here. I like signing mine with my last name. Some people like to use their initials. I also like putting the year in. The year that it was painted. That way you can see your progression and what you were thinking at the time. Well, I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you're painting along with me, and thanks for watching. Bye.